Hello everyone. Now we will cover the next topic in the DML operation, select statement with the aggregate functions, right? So in this session, I will cover in detail how we can use this select statement with the aggregate function, the use of aggregate function, group by clause and having clause in the select statement, right? So with syntax, with example, we will cover in detail today. So as you know, here the select statement syntax, right? So here we can use the group by clause, having clause. So in this session, I will cover the syntax for this group by and having clause in detail. So in real life application also, we know that many times we need to use the aggregate function, right? To display the aggregate result of the set of values, right? So group functions are built in SQL function that operate on groups of rows and return the one value for the entire group, right? So these group functions are available in the SQL, right? Those return a single value as output from the set of values after executing these functions, right? So these are some functions available in the SQL that we can see with an example. So count function is there, maximum function is there, count function to retrieve the count value of the set of values, right? Then maximum value from the set of values, then minimum values from the set of values, average of the set of values and sum of the set of values and so on. So with example, we will cover here how we can use these aggregate functions, right? These aggregate functions are also called as the group functions. You can remember, student, right? So we will see with example here, right? So count is the function that returns the number of rows in a table that satisfy the condition specified in the where clause, right? So always we put this condition in the where clause or having clause, right? So having clause also I will cover here how it is different than the where clause in this session only, right? So if you want to display, right, here the total number of employee in the finance department. Here is the example, right? Find the number of employees in a particular department, right? So here, if my condition is key display all the employees, total number of employees in the finance department. So how we can write this select count star, right? So always we use this aggregate function after the select clause, right? You can remember, student, many students make mistake here. They confuse where to use these aggregate functions, right? So after select clause, always we use the count function. Why we use here? Count function means any function here, because the result of this count function will be the single value. And this single value will displayed as a, this single value is displayed as a column in the result, right? So definitely this will be one of the column in the result, right? So that's why always we use this aggregate function in the select clause, right? So after select clause, there will be aggregate function. So my query is here, display total number of employees in the finance department. And this aggregate function we are using with the whole table here. Right? So select count star from employee. So we want to display here the total number of employee of the complete employee table, right? Not on the part of the data of the table, right? So from complete table, I want to retrieve this count of the employee for the finance department. So here the condition is where department is equal to finance, right? So if this is my data in the table, right? This is my actual table here. So there are total four records, right? So if you observe, there are two records, employee with the finance department. So my result will be count star two. Right, so this name of the function is given as a temporary column to the result here. You can remember, student. You can also change this you can change this column name with the help of as, right? Aliasing. It's called as the aliasing. So after mentioning here count star, you can say as total employee, my user defined variable that you want as a column name in the result, right? So if you want total EMP here as a result, right? Then you can use here aliasing, right? So this is one example of the count function. So my result will be two. Similarly here, we can use the other functions like minimum, maximum functions. But before that, I want to discuss here the distinct clause that we can use with this aggregate function. So here is the example, right? If you want to select all the distinct department names from the employee table, right? So distinct department name you want to select from the table, employee table, right? So my query will be here, right? Select distinct department from employee, right? So already we have covered in short this use of the distinct, right, clause, right? So here it will display the distinct values. It will avoid the repeated repetition in the department, right? So how many departments are there in my table? Three departments, right? So my result will be finance, IT, and make. Even though my finance is repeating here twice, in the result it will display only once. So that is the use of my distinct clause here, right? So this distinct clause also we can use with the aggregate function, right? For example here, right? If you want to use this function to select the distinct rows, right? And to count the distinct values from the table, right? So to get the count of employee with the unique name, right? The query will be this, right? For example here, in our example, actually all the names are distinct. So my result will be count 4 only, right? But if there are 2 employee with the pile, so my count will be 3. If you use here count department, right? Count distinct department. So my result will be 3 here, right? So select count in bracket distinct name. My solution is what? Select count. Instead of star here, now I am using the distinct name. Here you can also, instead of star, you can also mention the field name, right? That you want to count in the table. Right, so here I want to count which field, that is name field of the employee, right? But here there can be multiple name with the same name in the table, right? So instead of considering the duplicate values, if you want to consider only a distinct value, then you can use here distinct word, right, from employee. So result will be 4 because all the names are distinct here, right? So if you apply this count function with the distinct department, right, then it will display the result, that is 3. I hope student you are clear with this. Then see the example of maximum operation, right? So this function is used to get the maximum value from the column, right? To get the maximum salary drawn by the employee. Here is the example, right? To find the maximum salary drawn by the employee, the result, the query will be select max salary. Now here, because we want to find the maximum salary, my condition is based on the salary field here. Right, and my function is max function, right? So select max in bracket salary from employee. Employee is my table name, right? So my result will be here, maximum salary from this table. So if you observe, my second record is having maximum salary here, right? So all the from all this set of values, this set from this salary set of values, my maximum function will return the maximum value of this salary. Right, so this is my result of this query. I hope student you are clear with this. Then next is the minimum function. Here again, same as your maximum function, you can use the minimum function to retrieve the minimum salary from the table. If you observe, 10,000 is the minimum salary, right? Then my result will be 10,000 here, right? So if you observe, the name of the column is same as the function name here, right? So because this is the temporary result, right? That you can store in the programming, you can store into the variable and then you can display on the form, right? So this actually value is not available in the table. From the table, we are deriving or calculating this value with the help of these functions, right? And that's why this is temporary result in one of the variables. So you can store and display on the screen, right? So this is an example here. So by default, this query gives the name to the result, that is minimum salary, that is name of the function, right? Also you can change with the help of aliasing here. Another example is the average function. Also many time we need this function to find the average value of the set of values, right? So select here average salary from employee. So this will return the average salary of your employee table, right? So here is the average salary of all the employee in the table. Now whatever function we have discussed here, that we are applying on the whole table, right? You can remember this, right? Now here the next function is the sum function. So like your average salary function, you can use here sum function to display the total salary here of all the salaries. So here my query is select sum of salary from employee, right? So here is the result, right? So 1,23,000 is the sum of all salary in the employee table as a result, right? Now see, student, whatever queries we have discussed and whatever values we have retrieved with the help of aggregate functions are taken from or applied on the whole table, right? Means the set of values are from the complete table. Now, if you want to find out these aggregate values for the part of the or group of the data in your table, right? Then you can use your group by clause. Right. So in the previous example, we have found the sum of salary for the complete table, right? All the employees. But if you want department wise sum of salary, right? If you want department wise, means you want to find out the sum of salary for finance department, sum of salary for mechanical department, sum of salary for IT department separately, right? Means we want to find out these sum of salary for the different groups, right? So these groups will be what? The departments. Right? So there can be multiple employees in the IT department, multiple employees in the mechanical department, multiple employees in the finance department, right? So there will be groups of this department, employees in the department, right? So if you want to find out department wise sum of salary, then you need to use here group by clause, right? So here the SQL group by clause is used along with the group functions. So alone we can't use group by clause. Always we use this group by clause with the group functions, means aggregate function to retrieve the data group according to one or more columns, right? To retrieve the data group according to one or more columns. So here is the example. If you want to know the total amount of salary spent on each department, right? As we discussed, my query will be select department comma sum of salary, right? In the previous example, we discussed after select clause, directly we use the aggregate function, group function. But now I want to do here grouping, right? Group wise, I want this sum of salary, right? So here my first attribute or field will be group by column, right? This grouping attribute on which you want to do the grouping, right? So on which you want to use the aggregate function. So here my department is the group by column, right? So always this come first and then we write the sum of the sequence can change here, no problem. But here many student confuse key which column to use here, either salary or department. But department wise we want salary, that's why my department will be the first attribute here, and second I want the sum of salary. So you can remember, student, the result, what I want, the name of the department and also the sum of salary of the department, right? So that's why this column list should be the group by column, and second the aggregate function that we want value in the output, right? So my query will be select department comma sum of salary from employee group by department. Right. So if you are not using group by clause here, what will happen? It will display only sum of salary, but there will be error. Why? Because department column we are using, and department my compiler will confuse here ki which department to display in the result. Right. So that's why here this group by clause is very, very important if you want to display the department wise here sum of salary. Right. So result of this query will be this. So for every department, finance, IT and MEC, my sum of salary will be displayed in the result. I hope, student, you are clear with this. You can see this 33,000 is on 33,000 is the sum of salary of the finance department. So here 10,000 plus 23,000. So total sum is 33,000, right? Then here there is only single employee in the IT department, that's why my sum is 40,000. Single employee there in the mechanical, that's why my sum is 50,000, right? So this is my result of the group by query. I hope, student, you are clear with this. Then here is the another example of the group by clause, right? So not only single column we can use here with the grouping function, right? But also nested grouping is also possible, right? Means multiple field names you can use with this grouping function. So here is the example. We want to find out here sum of salary department wise and location wise, right? So nested grouping we want to apply here with the help of aggregate function and group by clause. So here is the solution: select department location comma sum of salary from employee group by department and location. So instead of only department, we want also location to consider for the grouping, right? So that's why we can mention here multiple column by giving the comma, right? So what will be the result of this query that we can see here? This is my original data, that is actual table, right? Now I want what? Department wise and location wise sum of salary. As you know, always my result of the query is in the ascending order. That's why my finance department is appearing first, right? By default it is ascending order always. That's why my always finance department is here coming first, right? So if you observe here, right, my first finance department is of Payal, right, whose location is what? Mysore. Then Paresh department is also finance and whose location is Pune, right? So here this sum of salary I want department wise and location wise, right? So for, because there is a single record in the finance department, single record in the Mysore for the finance department and single record of the Pune for the finance department. So there means aggregate function will not work here because single record is there, right? So that's why my sum of salary is here finance Pune 23,000, then finance Mysore 10,000, right? So this is happening first because alphabetically it is coming first, right? Mysore and then Pune, then here Pune, then Mysore, then IT also having single record and make also having single record. So this is my result. So in the result, if you observe, my first column is this department, this then location, right? So whatever column you mention here in this select clause appear in the result, right? So that's why my first column is department, then location, and then sum of salary here, right? So I hope, student, you are clear here. This is the example of nested grouping, right, with multiple columns. Now, what is the use of having clause? No? You might have doubt here, right? So here, having clause works like a where clause, right? Only one of the limitation of where clause is what? We can't use aggregate function, right, in the where clause. Means if your condition is based on the aggregate function, right, then we can't use in the where clause, right? Where clause don't accept the aggregate functions, and that's why they have provided separate clause, that is having clause, which is similar to the where clause, right, which is similar to the where clause for matching the criteria. Having clause also used for filtering the data, but which data? That we use are finding with the help of grouping operations, right? Group by clause, right? So always, always my having clause comes with the group by clause. So you can remember this is the pair, group by clause and having clause. These two are the friends, close friends in the select query, right? So always these two comes together, right? Without group by clause, we can't use having clause, but having clause is optional. Why it is optional? Whenever only there is a condition, then only we use the having clause, right? So here we can see the example, right? So if you want to display here department wise total salary, right? Department wise total salary, and here this salary should be more than 25,000. This sum of salary of the department should be greater than 25,000. So here is the result of the query: select department sum of salary from employee group by department having sum of salary is greater than 25,000. Here my condition is based on sum in bracket salary and then greater than 25,000, right? So having clause we are using to put the condition on this aggregate function. This sum of salary we can't use in the where clause, and that's why it is provided here, right? So sum of salary greater than 25,000. So result will be this only two departments are here in the result, 40,000 and 50,000. IT is having salary, finance is having salary 10,000 only. That's why it is excluded from the original table, right? So my result is only two department along with this sum of salary here. I hope, student, you are clear with this. Here is the another example of group by clause for the different table. Here I assume there is one table employee master along with the branch details, right? So here I want to display here, find out the how many employees are there in each branch. Like department wise total employee, here only we are using the branch word, right? So select branch number as a branch number. Here we have, this is the example of aliasing. If you want this spelling in the result as a column name, you can use space here, and in double quote that column name you can mention here. Or also you can use as is optional here. Here, as is optional. So either you can use space here or you can use as branch number. That is, both are correct. Both are alternative methods, right? So select branch number as branch number from count employee number, right? I want to count here number of employee in each branch. So here, instead of now count employee number in the result, I want column name number of employee. If you are writing this string in a double quotation, no need to use underscore here, right? So this complete string will be given as a name to the resultant column in the display, right? From employee master, my table name, group by branch number. Now my grouping field is here, branch number. Branch wise, I want to display here total number of employees. So if you observe, this is my actual table. My name of the table is employee master here, right? So branch number and employee number, these are the two columns in the table. So if you observe, there are three records of B1 branch. There are two records of B2 branch, one record of B3 and one record of B4 branch, right? So like this, we want to do grouping here. So I want to find out total number of employee because we are using count function here, right? So count 1, 2, 3. So there are three employees in the B1 branch, right? Again, we are using count function for the second group, right? We are doing grouping, right? So here for B2, count will be 2. And for B3, it will be 1. For B4, it will be 1. So this will be my result of this query. So if you observe, my first column is branch number that we have given here. Small BRAN number is there. Then number of employees, my second column name, right? And these are the branch names. B1, B2, B3, B4. And these are the counts. Those we have calculated using the count function here, right? So this is my result of the group by query here. Branch wise total number of employees. This is also one best example that have covered the aliasing part here, right? This is again another example, right? Only here we are using the having clause. Having clause can be used in conjunction with the group by clause, right? It imposes the condition on the group by clause. Right? It imposes condition on the group by clause. Means whatever result is given by the group by clause, if you want to filter out that result, then you can use the having clause. So here is the solution. Find out how many employees are there in each branch having total number of employees greater than 2. Means display here branch wise total employee, but which branch only those are having total employees greater than 2. Right. So here is the solution. Select branch number, comma branch. Here is a space branch number. Realizing count employee number from employee master group by branch name. Here my query is missing. Right. My next condition should be having count employee. My condition is what here? Total number of employee should be having employee number. My condition is on count, right? Number of employee should be greater than 2. So I want to display branch wise total count only for the branches whose count is greater than 2, right? So this is missing here in the query. So this is the use of my having clause, right? So select branch number. comma count employee number from employee master group by branch number. Now semicolon should not be there, right? After branch number, you can use having clause, having count employee number greater than 2. So result of this query will be this. So if you observe, only one branch is there, B1 branch, whose count is greater than 2, right? Whose count is greater than 2, right? That is 3. And that's why my result only contains the one record of B1 branch. I hope, student, you are clear with this example. Here we have discussed the having clause for filtering the data, right? So, and my condition is based on the aggregate function. This aggregate function we can't use in the where clause, and that only we can use with the having clause, right? And that's why it is required here, right? I hope you are clear with this. See, one more use of the group by clause using roll-up operator, right? So roll-up operator actually used to calculate the aggregates and super aggregates for the expression within group by statement. So here is the example, create a report of salary spent on employees at individual branch, right? So here branch-wise total employee salary we want, right? Branch-wise total salary of the employee along with the aggregate salary also we want for the complete branch, right? All the branches. So here you can see nested grouping is there. So my solution will be select branch number, sum of employee salary from employee master, group by, along with the group by, we are using here roll-up operator. Group by, roll-up, and branch number. So if you observe this result, right, my result is branch-wise sum of salary. Branch-wise sum of salary, and at last also my result is displayed with the total salary of all these sum of salaries, right? So this total salary of all the sum of salary will be displayed with the help of roll-up operator with the group by clause. I hope, student, you are clear with this. This is my actual table, and after executing this query, right, after executing query, my result will be this, right? So not only branch-wise total salary of all employee, but also the sum of salary of all the sums, right? I hope you are clear with this. The same is here, right? Thank you.